So, we ready to make a deal or what? Okay then, let's talk business. This is a war zone. There's product coming in here by the truckload. And you'll be picking up a lot of guns in the field, I'm sure. Whatever guns you don't need, I'll take and buy them off you. That'll earn you points you can cash in for services.
Like what?
I'll launder your ID guns, no more locks. And I can also sell you the guns I've got in stock. Let me show you. To ensure you can use non-ID guns, I'm gonna have to suppress the old nanomachines you got in you. Otherwise, they'll interfere with the system. Here, stick yourself with this. It's full of suppressor nanomachines. Relax, it won't hurt. You're scared of needles or something? See? No sweat. Now you can use non-ID guns, no problem. Hey, be nice to our guest. Step outside. Problem. From now on, when you pick up an ID gun that says lock, you just let me know. You name it, I can launder it. Of course, it'll cost you. The going rate depends on the war price at the time. Man, I gotta give this shit a rest.
Looks like you're doing pretty well for yourself.
You might say that. What with the war economy and all, and the system clamping down on things. System codes are the law now, and controls essentially absolute, paving the way for fat profits if you're willing to bend the law. Demand keeps on growing thanks to the war economy. I sell ID guns to the PMCs and state armies, and naked guns to terrorist groups and paramilitaries. And these ID guns can't be sold on the black market. System's practically a license for us arms dealers to print money. Privatizing the military's made the PMCs big and bloated. And the fatter the PMCs get, the line between civilian and soldier is gonna get real blurry. Sooner or later, the whole damn human race is gonna be green collars. More like, we're all gonna be fighting proxy wars. But hey, this war economy puts the food on my table. You're a green collar too, aren't you? Yeah, it's in your eyes. You've seen a lot of combat.
What makes you think you know me?
Nothing to be ashamed of. I'm the same way. I grew up here too. I got no interest in the outside world. All right then. If you need me, holla. We specialize in speedy service. Catch my drift? You.
Ach ja, der gute Drebin von der Spezialeinheit. Ja, einen neuen Freund. Mehr oder minder.
I know what you're thinking, but Drebin does have a point. The world depends on the war economy. Can you imagine what would happen if war just disappeared overnight?
Otacon, you and Drebin both mentioned something about a war price earlier. What did you mean by that?
It's a kind of market price, one that fluctuates according to demand, not only for PMCs and military industry, but for the production, distribution, and energy supply networks that support them. It's been growing by leaps and bounds, and investors are really starting to take notice. As the fighting in any given area becomes increasingly intense and prolonged, the war price goes up. No doubt Drebin's rates are linked to that war price. The longer and bloodier a battle becomes, the higher service prices are going to get. To put it another way, the quieter things are, the better the bargains. Snake, we'll use the Mark II to deal with Drebin from here on out. He's what you might call a street vendor. The Mark II can act as a kind of delivery boy, connect you with it. I'm adding a Drebin menu item to the Mark II's weapon menu. Whenever you pick up multiple units of the same weapon, any extras will automatically be sold to Drebin. Any ammo that's inside gets added to your cash. In other words, you keep the ammo, and the weapon itself gets traded to Drebin for points.
I see.
You can then use the points you've earned to unlock ID guns or buy new weapons.
Sounds good.
We should assume Drebin has other agents collecting guns for him besides you, Snake. You know, freelance green collars who collect weapons in exchange for services?
Guess I'll have to rely on him for now.
Okay. Now go meet up with our informants, Rat Patrol.
So, die M4 Custom ist jetzt unsere. Nicht, dass wir sie jemals benutzen würden, so wirklich, aber schön eine zu haben. Denn die ist wirklich schön customizable. Man kann Schalldämpfer draufschrauben, man kann Lampen ranschrauben, man kann Granatenwerfer unten drunter packen und so weiter und so fort. Also sehr schöne Sachen, die man bei Drebin dann erstehen kann. Lass mal gucken, ob wir. Great Bargains at Drebin's Shop every Wednesday and Sunday. Get 20% off. Na, da schauen wir doch mal rein. Drebin's Shop. So, alles glitzert und blinkt. Hier sind ein paar Handfeuerwaffen. Submachine Guns. Die Tangeshima. Das ist eine Geheimwaffe aus Metal Gear Solid 4. Die kostet extrem viel. Ist quasi eine alte japanische Einschussflinte. Und soweit ich weiß, hat die Möglichkeit, also eine gewisse Prozentchance bei einem Schuss, den man abfeuert, dass dann ein riesen Wirbelsturm wohl erscheint und ja, alles wegfegt. Wegfegt. Habe ich aber so auch noch nicht benutzt und oder gesehen. So. Pump Action, ne, Sniper Rifle. Also man kann sich hier alles organisieren. Sogar hier eine schöne Mosin Nagant, die man ja aus dem dritten Teil kennt. Eine Tranquilizer Sniper Rifle. Immer wieder schön. Stun Grenades, Granaten, Playboy, Master Key. Ah, genau, das ist Under Barrel Shotgun. Sowas gibt es auch noch. Dann Under Barrel Grenade Launcher. Oh, meine Güte. Ein Suppressor für die Operator, Suppressor für die M4. Ein Punktsichtgerät, ein normales Scope, Laser Sight, Handgun Light, Long Gun Light. Ein paar Grips, damit das Ziel nicht so verzieht und so weiter. Eine Static Rounds, meine Güte, Munition. Boah. Ja, also ein kleines Shop-System mitten im Spiel. Schön eigentlich. Werden wir irgendwann mal reingucken weiter. So, momentan nicht. Momentan komme ich eigentlich mit dem ganz gut
Snake,
zurecht, was ich hier habe.
hurry and get to the rendezvous point with our informants. First, you'll have to get to the other side of that collapsed building. The only way across is straight through.
Und wir gehen hier mal.
Careful, Snake. The walls could come down any second.
Nanu. Ja, treffen wir uns mit Red Patrol. Versuchen jeden Kontakt zu vermeiden. Mit bösen, bösen Buben. Und ja, sein Rücken. Snakes Rücken tut weh, wenn man zu viel croucht. Denn er ist ja mittlerweile ein sehr, sehr alter Mann. So, wir werden aber die Camouflage erstmal umstellen. Und zwar Octocamo Auto. Besser ist es.